When Lindelani's baby turned 4 years old, he began to explore his sexuality. However, his first visit to a gay club turned his life upside down.
He's naked and he's having a gun.
He thought that dire threat would be his greatest challenge. But then, the unexpected news struck like a storm.
I started getting sick, and then I found out that I was diagnosed with HIV positive.
What was it like to share his status with his partner and his family? Why did Lindelani end up living on the streets, and how did he manage to get back on his feet?
I started exploring my sexuality when I was 21 because I was still not sure about my sexuality, if I'm straight or I'm gay. Where we met with the baby mama, it was those things when we were young, playing outside the street. I'm the father, she's the mother. So we grew up Nalindole, which okay, we're still a mother, I'm still a father, until we started dating, having feelings for each other. We started having sexual intercourse, nae. That's where the baby comes. I think I knew that I'm gay, but I was still not sure. So I started experiencing dreams, sleeping with boys, not girls, and then having feelings to guys. I was questioning my sexuality, but I thought it's a demon and I will be fine, until I started dating after my baby mama was pregnant. That's where I started dating a guy. That's where I came out. Coming out, I didn't come out to my family or siblings, but I was dating this guy on Facebook. So he picnics our pictures and Wang Tega. That's where everyone like saw Wuti, or actually Lindelani came. She didn't take me serious until she saw me with the guy, and then I introduced that guy to her. When my baby was 4 years gay now, I started like being out there again now, but I was still in a closet. I was still dating that guy that was my first boyfriend. Started introducing me to gay clubs. We started going out. It was my first time going into that club, SMLville. And then we had a fight in that club. And then he left. So until I wanted to use my phone, and then I remembered, Uti, I left the phone in the car, Wambi and I. So I asked two guys, can you help me with the Bolt so that I can go home? They said, okay, fine, let us know when you want to leave. And then 30 minutes later, I went back to them, asked them, and then they said, we don't have data, but we're staying around. Can we go where we stay? Because we have Wi-Fi, we will use Wi-Fi, and then Zuhambela Corner Lab. And then we went to their place. It's not far from the club. We went to their place. I was standing outside, Bangena. And then a few minutes later, they called me. It's cold. You will wait for Imoto inside. And then I went out inside with the other one. When I get inside, Sengtola, the other guy, he's naked and he's having a gun on his hand. And then they said, we're gonna have fun. And then I asked, guys, how are we gonna have fun? Because I asked for help again. And then they say, undressed, and then yeah. We had a little fight now, but I was like, I can't think so, and that, because things are really, what's gonna happen? What if I die here? And then they won't get, my family won't get me. And then Nabayega, they did what they did. After they chased me outside, and then I went, because in that era, it was my first time, Gemelville. So I was just walking in the street until a security car in approach, asking what happened. I told them the story, tried to look for the house, but because I was drunk at that time, I didn't remember the house, but as I told, and then they drove to Bangisendlini, and then asked, you can go open a case tomorrow in. But for me, now opening a case, I was still afraid, I'm gonna be judged. Remember, I don't have much information, Uti. Guys do get raped now, and if you have a case, kids are alone. So, I didn't tell anyone until I think 2 months down the line, I started getting sick, and then I found out, Uti, I was diagnosed with HIV positive, and he told it to those guys. And then I started my journey, a treatment game, even though it was hard for me, because now I'm dealing with a case of rape. I still want to heal, and now I say I went, I think about depression for some time, because that's where I think started, like, because I was eating my dustbin. So I started supporting myself, Uti. Let me take this journey, my ARVs, and see Uti Zuenzala, because I've tried suicide 3 times. The single at stage, which I know I'm tired, I'm going through a lot, no one is supporting me. So the best solution in mailing entitled is Bolan. So when the security dropped me, so I started smoking drugs because I was still traumatized in Zagalili, and I'm still angry for my boyfriend. I fetched my phone the following day, and then because we're stubborn as school, I didn't reach out to him, Kim Jelly, about the rape, but I did say, yesterday. I'm gaga ready to talk about it, but yesterday. And then he was like, cool me nine. And I was like, no, fine. For the reason, Guti, shit lapin, knowing Guti, I'm not transport, knowing Guti, I don't have a phone. I disclosed to him after some time because we were having sex without a condom because I didn't know. I disclosed to him after finding out actually this is what's happening. And then that's where we broke up. When I tell him about the HIV, he blocked me same time. Before getting tested, I got sick. And so it was like, it's flu. 2 weeks down the line, I'm still sick. I'm losing weight. I have no appetite to eat. I can't walk because we were 5 or 6 of us. We're like, let's try, guys, and see what can happen. And then we went inside, but they got their status. And then Mina stayed long. I was still confused with what's happening. And then I asked the lady, can we try again until game one of it? Actually, I'm positive. And then they started counseling me, it's not the end of the world, I should, they refer me to a bar to start the treatment as soon as possible because I think we're saying when stage. I think after finding out, I did call all my siblings, telling them Guti, I'm HIV positive, but I didn't tell them about the rape part. But I told them Guti, because for me, I was like, I'm dying, you know, I'd rather die, because really, this is what I wanted to do, ugufa, because I've been through a lot of things, and then now nainale, so I'm gonna use it, Guti ngathatha treatment, ngiveleng if you want. And then I think they came, bang support, they supported me. I started my journey with my ARVs. In that journey, still I'm alone. At first, it was hard taking medication every day. It was hard thinking, now I'm not gonna date because maybe some people are scared of food. Oh, you have HIV, you're just telling, but for me now, it was not that difficult because as soon as I started dating, I disclosed my status, Guti, this is what's happening. But I've been getting support to all the people that I've dated, Mangbajel, about my status. I disclosed my status on Facebook. So I was kidnapped in Johannesburg. These people, they came to me, Bafiye Bapaga, Pamguam, Bapaga. So I was like confused, Guti, actually, this is a hijack. It was not in hijack, and then the other two, Bakibela Nami, and then we followed the other car. We went to, it was the last GP in Johannesburg, and then we went there. They wanted my bank account, my phones, and then they undressed me. So for me now, it was, here we go again, okay, things were rape for the second time, because there was this guy, Bigaluka Lalang, we're gonna rape you when I saw Munduami. So all they did was like Biba Funi Mali, but he called all the people that you know Basendi Mali. So they took Imali to my account, they took in Imali from the people. So they wanted to take Imoto Foti. But I lied, Kego Mati, no, the car is not mine, I got put Wami in the police, because they saw Namapepe that being Guiscolin. So they saw it in paper manning means, so they thought it really a poise. So about Wazang with Tatima, because Bang was in a trek, which ain't that you mean I don't know Guiscolin. So the Montazang by Tati, the able to Tatimoto email through people and in my account. The time I was homeless, it started like I was supposed to go to Ireland selling my furniture, like everything that I had. ukuthi actually I'm buying tickets ngale mali le. By cancel trip yam on the day kumele ngihambe ngayo because the reason being my passport was still clean. Angazi nga traveler anyway. So the imali ebenginayo in my account esingisele nayo bese ngihambe ngilala like every day I'll change ama BNB. Book this BNB. Angilali. I feel like there's some people abangilandelayo nabantu abafuna ukungibulala. There are a lot of things ezenzakalayo, you know. For me, it's hard to eat, it's hard to ugeza. So angisazi kwenzakalani. So ngihambe ngiyahlala like BNB ngesantini nini ngiyatravela ngiyakuphi 4 ways yabo until imali sengibona ukuthi seyaphela. I went to another church ebese santini. I went there ngayocela usizo indawo yokuhlala and then they gave me an address yale shelter engisebenzelayo manje. They gave me that address. It was a weekend bayavala ama social worker asebenzi during weekend. So I have to wait futhi. So abona ukuthi okay because angisenamali ukuthi ngizohamba ngibhuka. Imali engiselina ukuthi ngigibele ngejozi at least ngibe closer to that shelter. So ngihamba ngalala emaboneni outside. And the following day ngiye. The reason ngiyenza yonke lento, I know ukuthi if I reach out there's like no one who is gonna help me. I had friends but I know ukuthi banjani. If ngithi kwenzakala so ngilambile, no one will help me. So there was a club ke ebengilala kuyo. So uma ngilala kule club ngiyabona ukuthi okay, ngilala estrateni and going back to ama drugs food. Lokhu ngiyabuyela ngithi I'm gonna fight until ngithole indawo yokuhlala in that shelter. That's where I started ukuhlala e-shelter. Sengiqala impilo yami ngabusha ke nawo. Mase kabuya dude, where are you kwenzakala so and then azange ngitshele full story ukuthi okay, I'm homeless, what's happening? Because I'm afraid ukuthi abantu will judge me, yabo. Ukuthi this person was supposed to leave South Africa and now sekase shelter, being namanga and stuff like that. So we started talking with my fiance and he helped me, you know, athi wazosoqala impilo phansi and see ukuthi siyapi up until now. I think for me, life was hard until we started dating with my partner.